In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
Almighty God, from whom all must be open, all the sides know.
Yeah.
Thank you. and after 6 days, Jesus forbid his Peter and James and John's brother, and led him up to a high mountain of a bar. And he was transfigured before them, and his face shone like the sun, and his bars became flying as light. And behold, there appeared to them Moses and Elijah talking with him. And Peter said to Jesus, "Lord, it is well that we are here. If you wish, I will make 3 booths here, one for you, and one for Moses, and one for Elijah." He was still speaking when behold a bright cloud overshadowed them, and a voice from the cloud said, "This is my beloved Son, with whom I am well pleased. Listen to him." When the disciples heard this, they fell on their faces and were filled with awe. But Jesus came and touched them, saying, "Rise and have no fear." But when they lifted up their eyes, they saw no one but Jesus only. And as they were coming down the mountain, Jesus commanded them, "Tell no one a vision until the Son of Man is raised from the dead." The Gospel of the Lord.
Very appropriate within this Dominican Church of the Holy Rosary. We should be celebrating the Transfiguration, the fourth luminous mystery that St. John Paul II in his apostolic letter, Rosarium Virginis Mariae, called the mystery of light par excellence and the revelation of the kingdom now present in the very person of Jesus. Continued the Dominican connection, Father Ada Nichols writes, "This feast is one to exalt it, filled as it is with that heavenly beauty, love, and joy of God, now within our reach in Christ, our friend and brother." Just before today's Gospel begins, St. Matthew wrote that from the day Peter confessed that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of the living God, he began to show his disciples that he must go to Jerusalem and suffer many things, and be killed, and on the third day be raised. Peter scorns this prediction utterly, but our Lord grounds on him, calling him Satan, a stumbling block, with a mind set not on the things of God, but of man. No, Peter must deny himself, take up his cross, and follow the Lord even to death. This is the context in which the mysterious episode of the Transfiguration takes place on a high mountain, traditionally Mount Tabor, before Peter, James, and John. The same three witnesses he chose to be with him in his agony in Gethsemane on the Mount of Olives. His face and clothes become dazzling with light, and Moses and Elijah appear speaking of his exodus, St. Luke writes, the paschal mystery that he was to accomplish at Jerusalem. The glory cloud covers them, and the Father's voice is heard. This is my beloved Son, with whom I am well pleased. Listen to him. For a moment, our Lord discloses his divine glory, confirming Peter's confession. He also reveals, as I said, that he would have to go by the way of the cross on Mount Calvary to enter into his glory. Moses and Elijah had seen God's glory on the mountain. The law and the prophets had announced Messiah's sufferings. And they'd also fought against evil personified in Pharaoh and Jezebel and the prophets of Baal. And so the Holy Trinity is disclosed. Our Lord's passion is the will of the Father. The Son acts as God's servant. And the cloud indicates the presence of the Holy Spirit. As St. Thomas said, the whole Trinity appeared. The Father in the voice, the Son in the man, the Spirit in the shining cloud. The symmetry is beautiful. On the threshold of his public life, we have Jesus' baptism. On the threshold of the Passover, we have his transfiguration. His baptism proclaimed the mystery of the first regeneration, our baptism. The transfiguration is the sacrament of the second regeneration, our own resurrection. From now on, we share in the Lord's resurrection through the Spirit who acts in the sacraments of the Church. The transfiguration also gives us a foretaste of Christ's glorious advent, when he will change our lowly body to be like his glorious body. But it also recalls that it is through many persecutions that we must enter the kingdom of God. Many persecutions. Listen to St. Augustine. Peter did not yet understand this when he wanted to remain with Christ on the mountain. It has been reserved for you, Peter, but for after death. For now, Jesus says, go down to toil on earth, to serve on earth, to be scorned and crucified on earth. Life goes down to be killed. Bread goes down to suffer hunger. The way goes down to be exhausted on his journey. The spring goes down to suffer thirst. And you, Peter, refuse to suffer? Pope Benedict, perhaps with this passage of his beloved Augustine in mind, said at World Youth Day in Cologne, by making the bread into his body and the wine into his blood at the Last Supper, Jesus anticipates his death. He accepts it in his heart, and he transforms it into an action of love. What on the outside is simply brutal violence, from within becomes an act of total self-giving love. This is the supernatural transformation which was accomplished at the Last Supper and was destined to set in motion a series of transformations, leading ultimately to the transformation of the world when God will be all in all. A series of transformations. To transform or to transfigure translates the same verb in Greek. It is our task, by grace and effort, with fear and trembling, as St. Paul says, to be increasingly transformed into the image of Christ, and being conformed to him, to become the human person he created us to be. St. Paul describes these gradual transformations into Christ in this way. And we all, he wrote to the Corinthians, with unveiled face, beholding the glory of the Lord, are being transformed, transfigured, into the same image from one degree of glory to another. Another Dominican, who has a titular see not far from here, has written,
only the inexhaustibly rich, perfect image of God, who is the person of the Son, could constitute the principle and pattern for the transformation and fulfillment of every human person that has ever lived. To become fit for communion with the Holy Trinity, a life we have already entered upon, we must constantly seek pardon and peace from the Father of Mercies through the ministry of the Church for the deadly effects of our sins, already overcome by Christ's passion, death, and resurrection. And Pope Benedict reiterated that the agent of these transfigurations is the Eucharistic sacrifice, the sacrament of transfigurations, he said, indeed, a series of transfigurations, the presence in our midst of the Creator, who gives himself into our hands and transforms us as he transforms the bread and wine and thus transforms the world. It all tends to the definitive renewal of man and the cosmos at the end of time. Christ's flesh and blood and ours becomes one, and in him we too are transfigured into that heavenly beauty, love, and joy of God that he is, so that we may be agents of sanctification in this darkling world. So let us begin again this evening, on this little mountain, in this little cloud, with Moses and Elijah, Peter, James, and John, with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven.
Thank you.
Let us pray for the whole Church of God in Christ Jesus and for all men according to their needs. Almighty and ever-living God, who are thy holy apostle, has told us to make prayers and supplications and give thanks for all men. The young and deceased most mercifully to receive these our prayers which we offer in the light of thy majesty. Beseeching thee to inspire continually the universe of church with the spirit of truth, humility, and one hope. We grant that all men will be blessed and in him, and in
our sins.
Oh.
Therefore, most merciful Father, we humbly pray you, through Jesus Christ, thy Son, our Lord, and we ask that thou accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices. We offer them unto thee first for thy holy Catholic Church, that thou vouchsafe the people in peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world. Together with thy servant Francis, our Pope, Jeffrey, our Ordinary, and Alexander, the local bishop, and all the faithful guardians of the Catholic and Apostolic Church. Remember, O Lord, thy servants in the handmaidens, and all who here around us stand, whose faith is known unto thee, and their steadfast is manifest, on whose behalf we offer unto thee, or who themselves offer unto thee, this sacrifice of praise, for themselves and for all who are theirs, for the redemption of their souls, for the hope of their health and well-being, and who offer their prayers unto thee, the eternal God, the living and the true. United in one communion, we venerate the memory first of the glorious ever Virgin Mary, Mother of our Lord and God Jesus Christ, of Joseph her spouse, as also of thy blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon, and Thaddeus, Linus, Cletus, Clement, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysogonus, John and Paul, Cosmas and Damian, and of all thy saints. Grant that by their merits and prayers we may in all things be defended with the help of thy protection. We beseech thee then, O Lord, graciously to accept this oblation from us, thy Son, and from thy whole family, order thou our days in thy peace, and bid us to be delivered from eternal damnation, and to be numbered in the fold of thy life. Our Savior God, we beseech thee in all things to make this oblation blessed, approved, and accepted, a perfect and worthy offering, that it may become for us the body and blood of thy dearly beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. Who the day before he suffered, took bread into his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes lifted up to heaven unto thee, God, the Almighty Father, giving thanks to thee, he blessed, broke, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. The mystery of faith.
O Savior of the world, by thy cross and precious blood hast redeemed us. Save us and help us, we humbly beseech thee, O Lord.
Wherefore, O Lord, we thy servants and thy holy people also, remembering the blessed passion of the same Christ, thy Son, our Lord, as also his resurrection from the dead and his glorious ascension into heaven, do offer unto thine excellent majesty of thine own gifts and bounty, the pure victim, the holy victim, the immaculate victim, the holy bread of eternal life, and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Vouchsafe to look upon them with a merciful and pleasant countenance, and to accept them, even as thou didst vouchsafe to accept the gifts of thy servant Abel the righteous, and the sacrifice of our patriarch Abraham, and the holy sacrifice of the immaculate victim,
which thy high priest Melchizedek offered unto thee. We humbly beseech thee, Almighty God, command these offerings to be brought by the hands of thy holy angel to thine altar on high, in sight of thy divine majesty, that all we who have partaken of the altar shall receive the most sacred body and blood of thy Son, may be fulfilled with all heavenly benediction and grace. Remember also, O Lord, thy servants and handmaids, who have gone before us sealed in the seat of faith, and who sleep the sleep of peace. To them, O Lord, and to all that rest in Christ, we beseech thee to grant the abode of refreshing, of light, and of peace. To us sinners also, thy servants, who hope in the multitude of our mercies, vouchsafe to grant some part and fellowship with thy holy apostles and martyrs, with John, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicitas, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and with all thy saints, within whose fellowship we beseech thee, admit us, not weighing our merit, but granting us forgiveness. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, through whom, O Lord, thou dost ever create all these good things, thus sanctify, quicken, bless, and restore them upon us. By whom and with whom and in whom, to the Almighty Father in the unity of the Holy Spirit, be all honor and glory throughout all ages, world without end.
Amen.
As our Savior Christ has commanded and taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father,
Christ, our sacrifice for us.
Therefore, let us keep the peace.
Almighty and ever-living God,
we most heartily thank thee for the doubt of sickness, with the spiritual fruit of the most precious body and blood of thy Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and thus assure us thereby of the great goodness of our souls, and that we are very members of the flesh and the mystical love of God, thy Son, bless us from the view of all faithful people, and are also heirs to the hope of thy everlasting kingdom, by the merits of the most precious death and passion of thy dear Son. And we humbly beseech thee, O heavenly Father, so to assist us with thy grace, and that we may continue in that holy fellowship, and do all such good works that thou hast prepared for us to walk in, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Then gave me the power to become the Son of God.